Originally considered a bold plan, the concept of repurposing open space beneath the Metrorail to create a pedestrian-friendly trail is another step closer to reality following approval of a multi-million dollar state grant. The goal of the project is to transform a 10-mile stretch from Brickell to Dadeland into a series of recreational spaces and trails, adding more adequate lighting and safer crosswalks, creating what is known as a linear park. Though similar parks have been created in Paris and New York City to much success, is this an attainable plan for Miami? Joining me to discuss this plan, we welcome Meg Daly, President and CEO of Friends of the Underline, and Marta Viciedo, founding partner of Urban Impact Lab and member of the committee for the Underline project. Thank you both for being here today.
Thank you.
Our pleasure.
Thanks. So, Meg, let me start with you. You are involved very heavily. You're a founder of the Friends of the Underline program. Tell us how you got involved in this.
Well, long story short, it started with a bicycle accident about 3 years ago, and I broke both of my elbows. And at one point, I was walking below Metrorail to get to physical therapy in Coconut Grove, and I thought, there's so much land here, and I'd been to the High Line in New York, and I thought, why aren't we doing something with this land and return it to the community? And that was the inspiration and beginning of our adventure.
So let's get some nuts and bolts out of the way. Is the project going to be a reality? Has it been approved by the County Commission and other folks that need to give approval, regulation?
This is all county-owned land. It's the rapid transit zone for Metrorail. And we went through a very robust public process with six public meetings. Our design team was selected through a competitive process, James Cornerfield Operations out of New York, who did the High Line. And we completed our master plan in the fall. Federal Transit Authority is reviewing our proposals, and once that's approved, we expect to be approved by the County Commission.
Mm-hmm. And so when might that occur?
Well, probably in the next couple of months.
Okay.
We've also secured $7 million of funding. You mentioned the state grant, which was a recent appropriation. But we also have had incredible support from the county. We have a unanimous endorsement from BCC. We also have municipalities that have endorsed the project. And the county has really committed the Parks Department and the Transit Department and their team, and also $3 million of funding from the county from road impact fees.
And how much do you expect the project to cost overall?
The transit component of it, the alternative, the trail itself, is about $8 million a mile. Plus, we have to improve over 30 intersections, and all of them are designed for cars and not for people on bikes or on foot. So that's another $20 million. So the total cost is about $10 million a mile.
Okay. And before I get to Marta, let me ask you about the distance and where it runs and how that area was selected.
The footprint is from the Miami River down to Dadeland South. And at the Miami River, we connect to the Miami River Greenway, which also takes us up to the airport, and then from the airport on the proposed Ludlam Trail down to Dadeland South. So our 10 miles is from Dadeland South up to the river. And that parcel was selected really because of the simplicity of land ownership. It's all owned by the county. Once you get over the river, which we intend to, it's a sort of a very difficult matrix of whose right-of-way is what, and it would be more likely a protected bike lane going through downtown into other parts of the county.
Mm-hmm. Let me ask Marta then, as an urban planner and someone who has your finger on the pulse of these types of projects in the community and around the country, why do you support this specific Underline project?
Well, I really believe that the project is transformative. It embodies everything, a number of issues that we have missed along any other transit development in the county thus far. And so when Meg talks about the project, she can dig into the economic impact of it, the health aspects of it, the coordination with how the land around the corridor that she's envisioned is going to be used, is going to be repurposed. The coordination that she has driven just by herself, nimbly, coordinating with multiple municipalities, the county, FDOT, the state. I can't even begin to imagine the amount of work that it takes to be able to pull off what she is pulling off. And she's done it quickly. So why I support it? Because it's a beacon of what we need to be doing for transportation planning from now into the future. for Miami-Dade County.
So can you tell us a little bit how this may help with transportation? If people are using the area underneath the Metrorail, which runs along US 1 in Miami-Dade County, they may have some recreational spaces. You may get a few people biking to their location. But wouldn't this potentially add more traffic because of the intersections? And if you have more people in that congested area, isn't it just going to cause so much trouble for an already congested area?
Two things. One, I don't think that it's going to add congestion. It's going to add use to the trail. People are going to, we're talking a space that's right underneath a transit corridor. So essentially there's access through any metro rail stop, any of the metro rail stations, right? The corridor is also accessed through multiple, it has multiple inserts through just different non-motorized pathways. If it becomes popular, it's the alternative to being in your car. It's the reason to get out of your car and either drive to the bike to the metro rail, walk to the metro rail, walk to the underlines. It will really take away the congestion.
Yeah, so this obviously would be accessible to the Metrorail because it runs right underneath it.
Right.
Yeah, what types of things will people do there then? So would the idea to be expand a bike path? Would there be other exercise and other recreational facilities there?
Well, I just want to circle back real quickly to what Marta was addressing.
Okay.
One of the conditions of our county funding was we had to have a traffic study. And that traffic study proved that we'll be able to reduce congestion on US 1 by redirecting people to walking and biking as opposed to driving, in particular a short distance. So a lot of those cars that you see parked at those transit stations have driven a mile. And you would never think about going to New York and driving a mile to get to a transit station or a half a mile. And people do it here because there's not a safe condition to walk or bike. And so we want to fix that.
That was one of the things I was wondering before we run out of time. What about the safety issue? Would this be dangerous for people who are there late at night or, again, with the traffic interference?
Well, I think one of the problems we have here is a safety condition. And it comes from two things. One is just being susceptible to being hit by a car. Miami-Dade County is the fourth most dangerous place to walk in the country and the most dangerous place to bike in the state. And the state of Florida is the most dangerous place to bike in the country. And so one of the reasons of that is really that we don't have safe conditions. We don't have infrastructure for me to walk or bike safely. And we think that this will, once implemented, will catalyze how the rest of the city and the county is planned. The second is there's no lighting. And so once you add lighting and you activate a space, then you have a safe condition.
And Marta, what do you hope this project will accomplish? Is it successful? What would make it successful?
Well, I think one of the things that it's really accomplishing is setting a standard for how we can do transportation overall at the county. Meg mentioned earlier the cost of the project, so $120 million. But the economic impact studies that she's had done indicate that there's $50 million that comes back annually, economic output.
How would it generate economic activity?
Well, the economic activity is generated from redirecting the use along the corridor, the pop-up shops that she's talking about, introducing, it increases the county tax base, property values go up. So the county makes money, the cities make money. It brings jobs in. I think it's 400 jobs, 400
annually.
Permanent jobs. Because there's so much use along the corridor. So we're talking about transit as it should be. And when I say transit, I'm talking about pedestrian, bicycle, mass transit. Transit planned as it should be, that really impacts the community in health perspective, from the economic perspective, from just a general interaction connectivity perspective.
And we're in our last half minute. Meg, you guys are having an event on Saturday. Tell us about it.
Free. Family-friendly fun. Bike the Underline. You can start to ride your bike with a large group. We have 250 people signed up for our bike ride from South Miami Metro Rail Station to Brickell Station. We have events at South Miami Coconut Grove and Brickell. You can do outdoor yoga, Zumba, chalk events for kids, so please come out tomorrow.
Okay, we hope to see people there. Thank you very much. For more information on the Underline project and its progress, visit theunderline.org. Thank you to Meg and Marta. I'm Sean Foreman. Thanks for watching.